In school, we were all taught during our basic science courses that Earth has experienced five big mass extinction events which forever changed the distribution of life forms as we know it today. For example, 66.043 million years ago, 76% of all species were rapidly wiped out, including all non-avian dinosaurs, when a 19-kilometer or 11.8-mile-wide asteroid impacted north of Mexico's Yucatan Peninsula, causing an impact winter. These five are referred to as the Big Five mass extinctions because they were each originally thought to represent the five most severe mass extinctions in Earth's history, with each instance wiping out at least 75% of all species then living on our planet. But what if I were to tell you that this line of thinking is now outdated due to the discovery and explorations of dozens of additional mass extinction events, most more minor, but some more severe than the extinction I just mentioned? Two of these, in fact, were more severe than some or all of the so-called Big Five mass extinctions, and the stronger of these events came the closest of any mass extinction to wiping out all life on Earth. What I am referring to are the end-Ediacaran mass extinction, which ranks as the fourth most severe, and the Great Oxygenation Event, which ranks as the most severe. Each of the now 33 known mass extinctions describe and tell us about a notable change in the world, with events ranging from the Carboniferous rainforest collapse to the Middle Miocene disruption to even the ongoing human-caused extinction during the Holocene. So, where do all of these mass extinction events rank in terms of severity? Here are the results, and I want to note that the ordering of this list is up for debate due to the broad range of estimates for the severity of many of these extinction events. Some opinion was also used from the author of this video in addition to select figures from a linked scientific paper. If you are wondering, I have decided to classify the 2nd through 7th most severe events as the Big Six, since they all occurred in the last 600 million years when more complex life existed, unlike the Paleoproterozoic Great Oxygenation Event. I will now briefly give a description for each of the 10 most severe mass extinction events in chronological order, also specifying what changes they caused to existing fauna. The Great Oxygenation Event started 2.46 billion years ago when cyanobacteria, which lived in environments devoid of oxygen since it was lethal to them, began to release large amounts of oxygen into the atmosphere. In essence, they nearly destroyed themselves, with this event getting the closest to destroying all life of any mass extinction on Earth, with many cyanobacteria species going extinct. Next, we have the 550 million-year-old White Sea-Nama transition, where a strong anoxic event in the oceans led to the first of two mass extinctions that would, when combined, wipe out almost all the fauna that the period was infamous for. The end-Ediacaran mass extinction 541 million years ago was the stronger of these two events, where flood basalts within a triple arm of what is today modern-day Oklahoma finished off the extinction of almost all of the aforementioned strange fauna that comprised this 96.2 million-year-long geologic period. This extinction paved the way for the rapid expansion of new organisms to fill these now missing niches, leading to what is known as the Cambrian Explosion. The End-Botomian mass extinction 517 million years ago wiped out many small-shelled creatures and sponges, only for the population of trilobites to figuratively explode thereafter. During the subsequent late Ordovician mass extinction 445 million years ago, much of the Cambrian fauna died out. The late Devonian extinction 372 million years ago wiped out most calcite reef-building organisms of the period and so badly impacted trilobites that their populations would never fully recover. The end-Capitanian extinction 259 million years ago wiped out many species, which would be further exacerbated by the so-called Great Dying 252 million years ago when trilobites, sea scorpions, most plant life, and many tabulate and rugose corals went extinct. The later Triassic-Jurassic mass extinction 201 million years ago left dinosaurs relatively unscathed, leading to their eventual dominance on the planet. And finally, the Cretaceous-Paleogene mass extinction event ended the dominance of non-avian dinosaurs 66 million years ago, leading to mammals becoming the dominant creatures worldwide. Ammonites were also wiped out by this extinction. I could easily make a full-length video on any one of these 33 mass extinctions, so if something catches your eye, let me know in the comments section below. As a final note, I would like to thank my new YouTube channel member, NoFo Not Forwards, for supporting my work.